you know, you get one person on a bike and they bring a friend and they encourage them to try. Like someone taught me how to bike and how to be comfortable just by saying, why don't you come with me? I'll show you. Just follow me around.
Yeah.
And it is more joyous, and it's an easy sell when someone starts to kind of get over that learning curve.
I'm here in downtown Pittsburgh on Liberty Ave and Commonwealth Place, where this new cycle track has recently been installed along with a raised bus lane to help cyclists get around the city more safely, more effectively, and contribute to the energy efficiency that bikes provide. How are some ways that you can get around a city that you love while also making sure that you're supporting a climate solution? Today, I'm talking with Paige Anderson, who works with the City of Pittsburgh to install bike infrastructure in lanes like this and ensure that not only she can get around the city that she loves, but also to improve the city and neighborhoods all over it for people just like her.
My name is Paige. I'm a project engineer at the City of Pittsburgh in the Department of Mobility and Infrastructure. So we manage all of the public right-of-way, so all of the roads and sidewalks and steps that we use for transportation in the city. And I work in the traffic division, so my job is to design and manage projects that make it safer to walk and bike and more comfortable for the residents of Pittsburgh to get around without using a car.
When did you become, like, it sounds weird to say, but like passionate about bikes and about like this type of work that you do?
Well, I know, I remember thinking about, when I was in middle school and high school, I started running on the track and cross country teams at school. And I was really excited because that was the first time. I grew up in a more suburban environment. Yeah. And that was the first time I think I found autonomy, you know, getting around it on my own by foot. And I started biking then for transportation. In college, I spent a lot of time studying cities and studying design. But I actually majored in architecture and took a lot of classes in like geography and urban studies. And so I started to think about more critically about the way we move around. I spent a little while working in architecture and then a little while at a nonprofit doing community outreach. And then I was really excited to find a position at the city 4 years ago. It was a fellowship. It was called a design fellow in the traffic engineering group. And they were excited that I had a background working with communities and doing outreach, and then also had a design background. And they helped me learn how to apply it to transportation and transportation engineering.
How did you get kind of on track, on the path with what you are doing at this point?
Even in college, I don't think I knew anything about traffic engineering. I would have been shocked if you had told me that that's where I'd be now. But I think I knew what I was excited about, which was like cities and design, and then I kind of remained open-minded.
Yeah, this is really interesting. How much are you thinking about climate in the work that you do? Where does it come in?
Cities are obviously bring a lot of problems for the climate, but there's a lot of solutions to be found in them. Sometimes people drive just because they don't feel safe and because they don't feel comfortable. And so making it safer and more comfortable is like a more natural way to do that, because I think a lot of people only drive because they feel like they have to. But a lot of people would really prefer to walk outside and go for a bike ride if they felt comfortable doing so.
How do you get people to open up to and embrace biking and getting around the city that way?
You know, you get one person on a bike and they bring a friend and they encourage them to try. Like someone taught me how to bike and how to be comfortable just by saying, why don't you come with me? I'll show you. Just follow me around.
Yeah.
And it is more joyous, and it's an easy sell when someone starts to kind of get over that learning curve.
Are there certain projects that you're like most proud of that you've gotten to work on?
I think the Neighborways have probably been my favorite in the past couple years. We just started to develop them when I started 4 years ago with the city, and now we've got six of them, or our sixth one is going in this fall as we wrap up the construction season. And so those projects are really great because we have really tight, narrow streets, and we don't have quite the capacity to just add bike lanes like you would see in a lot of cities. It's not the easiest city to navigate. And so especially if you're trying to avoid some of these like more dangerous feeling routes on your bike, you end up on these more residential routes that are great if you can find them, but sometimes a little bit confusing and, you know, not just right. So we're trying to find like creative connections that we can use. So the Neighborway that's right over there, I used to live over here, so I was very familiar with that route, and I knew I wasn't the only one that took it. It was a bit of a bike highway already. And so we just added a bunch of traffic calming elements to make it feel safer and make it more beautiful. And we also added a bunch of signs and different wayfinding mechanisms that made it just easier to use. And now I've actually moved away, but I still, every time I'm here, I swear there's more cyclists than there was even before. And it just seems like now the rest of the city can benefit from, you know, this natural connection that was already here for the community here.
What are like some of the most exciting parts of your job?
I just think it's so cool that I get to see my projects out there, like things, especially now that I've been here around for almost 4 years. There's projects that, you know, they were maybe wrapping up design when I started, but now they're just coming in now.
Are there any bike trips that you've had that have been like most notable or that you're most proud of?
At the beginning of this last summer, I went on my longest bike tour, and me and two of my friends, we biked across the coast of Maine from New Hampshire to the Canadian border, and it was really cool. And it was, I won't know if I would have done, I think it was a pandemic kind of sitting bored in our living room thinking, where can we drive and where can we bike? And it was really cool, it was very fun.
Do you have advice for people for young people especially, who might want to like follow in your footsteps and find that type of career that they're passionate about?
I guess just to be open-minded really helped me, because I didn't know what it would look like as I said earlier. So I think doing things you're passionate about, but like keeping an open mind to like adapting. I think I have a little more faith now to not get, you know, not stressed out about it, and trust that opportunities will come, but just be ready for them. Hi, I'm Paige Anderson, and I'm helping the world reach Drawdown by building better bike infrastructure.